We want to fact check the president's statement that both sides are responsible for the violence in Charlottesville. Video and photos from the scene show protesters and counter demonstrators fighting with each other. The white supremacist side appeared to be more prepared for the unrest. Paula Reed covered the protests in Charlottesville and witnessed much of the violence. Paula, good morning.
Good morning. The rally hadn't even officially started before clashes broke out in the park. We don't know exactly what kicked off that violence, but it's clear elements of both sides showed up for a fight.
Not all of those people were neo-Nazis, believe me.
Saturday's rally in Charlottesville was one of the largest gatherings of white supremacists in more than a decade. Hundreds came. The majority of them were armed with guns and batons, protected by shields emblazoned with racist symbols. The counter-protesters were overwhelmingly unarmed, but there were a number of Antifa or anti-fascist demonstrators who also used shields and sticks and clashed with white supremacists, but they were largely outnumbered.
You had a group on the other side that came charging in without a permit, and they were very, very violent.
It appears the worst violence came at the hands of white supremacists. James Fields Jr., who traveled from Ohio to join the neo-Nazis, was behind the wheel when counter-protester Heather Heyer was hit and killed. And a black man, DeAndre Harris, needed 8 staples in his skull after he was severely beaten in a parking garage. In May, a memo from the FBI and Department of Homeland Security warned of the persistent threat of lethal violence from white supremacists, who were responsible for 49 homicides in 26 attacks from 2000 to 2016, more than any other domestic extremist movement. Yesterday, the president insisted the pictures didn't tell the whole story.
It looked like they had some rough, bad people, neo-Nazis, white nationalists, whatever you want to call them. But you had a lot of people in that group that were there to innocently protest. So I only tell you this, there are two sides to a story.
We've reached out to law enforcement for official estimates of the crowd size, but for comparison, the last white supremacist rally in Charlottesville had a few dozen KKK members and approximately 1,000 counter-protesters. Charlie?
Thanks, Paula. CBS News Chief Washington correspondent and Face the Nation anchor.